Shalom.
Yeah, we're gonna come over before you get. All right, come on.
This is Revelation 17 and 3. It says, so he carried me away in the spirit into the wilderness. It says, so he carried me away into the wilderness, away in the spirit into the wilderness. And I saw a woman sit upon a scarlet colored beast.
Yeah, that woman that was sit upon a scarlet colored beast is who? Who's that woman at?
That is a man.
Go ahead.
That beast is
going back to the church. Let me ask you a question. So why everybody have it at Jesus'
land? Because the white man in power. And if you push that, keep it pushing that image.
Then put that in the negotiation.
Yeah. Now they did. They really have black. They really have black man upon the Bible and upon the history. But they in power.
How they get people to believe this thing so strong?
It's simple. It's simple. The more people that get to push it out, and the less people that have come against it, the more they keep you simple, you're never going to go and do research on your own. And say, well, nah, because the Bible is a black man, you're sitting there and receiving. What did he tell you? Because you tell yourself that what he tell you is true. So what he do is program people's mind to just accept whatever he say. Instead of going out and actually research and do their own study. The more, I think Hitler even said that the more you keep telling somebody a lie, they eventually go believe it.
If I may say this too, right? Like that movie Roots, and put that thing in the beginning, you start with Toby and Tim.
Yeah.
And then they get beaten here for ourselves. So when we actually come up with that image wrong, for illustration's sake, you understand? Yeah, you know, because I never been black. They tell me we curse, we this, we that, we something. So when you say the Lord was actually a dark skin guy, them don't want to hear that.
Yeah.
So that, how the hell are a white God going to take you to the white person?
You understand? That make no sense. Why bring? I bring that white God to take me under the white man oppression.
You understand?
And I see people.
And I bring you
up. You understand? So it make no sense.
No.
But what he saw white man did, he just basically this old school saying, I kill him with your own sword. I take your old weapon and kill him with it. This here is all book. This all four of us with this. Alright, so he's praying the Most High. And what he did is he just take it and twist it. And he see what's all with it. Because you know how we believe in all kinds of different badness basically. And say, now the word say, without horn say. What he say in the word say, that's not what it really means. Understand? I will have to remove it, actually show you that. And you say what you go to my nation yet. When you're not telling us say, that's how every scripture they bring to show me support me, that scripture basically. Cutting right. What he's saying.
Done.
And every scripture what he brings to say that is this way, that scripture is cutting what he's saying again. So that was he understood that. He said, nah, something wrong.
To preach certain things.
Exactly.
But they did really ignorant that. They might eat these pages good.
Uh-huh.
And start to read.
Yep.
And then you realize, hey, we are the people.
And they show that the so-called white man know who he is. They show, they know that when he had the Bible open and he was kneeling down praying, when he came and opened the scripture, he was watch up to the show. When the Most High tell him, go for and smite all Amalek. Of Amalek is Esau. They them so-called Jews right now. So he know Esau. The damn directors of them know very well. So the white man knows very well about the Bible who he is.
He
forefathers go back to.
Yeah. So then people will be making
it. Yeah, they didn't know. They didn't know.
How they did that?
Because they don't believe in the Most High. Understand? And they set up to do that. They set up, they get their orders from the high elite because they just low level elites, but they get to become the high elites, guys who really run the world. To say, hey, see that movie, push that movie, or put it in the movie. Blaspheme God, getting people to believe that God do exist, make mockery of all of them. You understand? But really and truly, they really making mockery of Heavenly Father and the Son. They making mockery of this guy. They making mockery of him because so
far from God. He walk on the earth.
No, not that. He did walk on the earth, but he's not the Son of God. Jesus is the only Son of the Most High. So by you blaspheming him, so-called blaspheming about Jesus, his hand meant to be the Heavenly Father's Son. Because the Most High said, whosoever curses God shall die. You understand? The amount of people that be blaspheming Jesus and making nothing happen to them. It's that people name the Son of Jesus.
Hey, so I'm interested in like, watching America, I think it's in France. Whatever the name is, they have been some kind of gay parade.
Yep,
yep. And they show two white men with Jesus and Christ.
Yep.
My name is terrible, I'm okay.
Yeah, you
when I'm okay, I'm okay.
Guys, that was the so-called Jews. Them so-called, them imposters, the guys who imitating us and trying to be us. They're really imitating us, they're claiming to be us. They call him what? Pasha? If you go to a regular so-called Jew, a Jewish person, and talk in the name of the Lord, they'll say, nah, we don't offer that word. That name is sacred, that sacred name. Man. You know, they show so much homage and respect to that name because they know to themselves, they're not supposed to utter that name. They know the name. But they just call him Hashem, which means the name. If they're praying, they say Hashem. If they talk about it, they say Hashem. They don't mention that name. Because they know to themselves that name is dreadful among them. You understand? They don't mention the name. You understand? They don't mention the name because they know that name can bring condemnation upon them. They don't mention the name. Even in other nations and all too who know the name of the Lord, they don't mention it. They'll say God. Or oh, that the creator, the great architect. They don't mention that name. You understand? They don't say the supreme being, the one who created all this. But they don't mention that name.
When you say it's terrible, like it's a terrible. Years on the shred.
Somebody give a second Thessalonians. Is that 2 and 3? Second Thessalonians 2 and 3. Because we are understand this so-called white man. He telling himself he's God.
What are you doing?
Yeah, rah. In the show, Egyptology is madness. Anybody who believes in Egyptology is a fool. Because if you didn't tell me that he's this great God, and he up in heaven, ruling the earth, governing everything, so yet every night they fight this demon. Every night they fight this demon for eating the earth, and you're born it. Who the hell created the demon that had to be fighting every night though? It makes no sense! And you the source of our life! So you created the demon to fight against every night?
You have nothing to do!
You have nothing to do?
I think me and Juliet to lose our world even but inside I think I used to tell you how we mixed up Egyptology.
Hey, Egyptology.
I was looking up at it. Right on over Ra is our next one they call Amun-Ra. And then they say it has two wives, which is Amun-Ra. Because now she named after that god Amunet, which means the mother of thing, and she has no creator or whatever the case is. Basically what they're trying to say is like Nimrod and
yeah, that would all go back to exactly because that were all these different religions have on the earth right now all stem from the worship of Nimrod and Semiramis. That would all boys them too. You understand? It all goes back to that. Because in the time of Nimrod, he was the one running at the point in time. And he was the one who was worshipped as a god then, him and his mother. So nowadays, they just had the worship of Nimrod and Semiramis as different names. Back then, it was Baal, Ashtoreth. Give my next one. Zeus.
Queen of Heaven.
Tammuz, the Queen of Heaven. Odin.
Thor. What about the books that created the Shia? Come on, God, by the end, by
the end. I know what happened. Who wrote that book? Egyptian book of the dead. Yeah, a lot of books predate the Bible. You understand? But that doesn't mean it's the truth. Because let me ask you something. Give me one prophecy the book of the dead spoke about. Mention. Give me one prophecy in the world like Kemet. Nah, name one.
I can't name it, you have to.
Well, from my research about Egypt, I have never heard about any prophecy coming out of Egypt. It did. But that doesn't mean it's true.
This Bible has not took the information from
you. No, it didn't. Because where they didn't understand is that back then, what do you think was into back then? Because everything here written out there in the stars and the tree of life. So what they did, they had knowledge of the tree and the stars back then. They read the stars and applied their own understanding to it.
If the book of the dead predates the Bible, right? If the book of the dead came through, and then what's in the Bible, in the book of the dead?
What's in the Bible, in the book of the dead? Because I have a lot of things
in the Bible. Same thing the Bible and
the
book of the dead.
That's to my knowledge.
I'll bring one to you.
That's to my knowledge. Because like I said, the book of the dead, this is a book of prophecy. The book of the dead have no prophecy. The book of the dead have no prophecy in it.
Same prophecy that this Bible has.
Name one. Christ was mentioned from since even in the time of Ptolemy. That Ptolemy the second, because that was Christ.
Listen, the word Christ means anointed one.
Yeah, or oil.
So anyone can be a Christ.
Or go back to Serapis.
So anyone can be a Christ.
Exactly.
Buddha was a Christ.
Yeah.
Krishna was a Christ. Jesus was a Christ.
But we understand. Jesus Christ have none to do the Son in Moses. That's not his name, that's not his title. Because the word Christ, like I said, goes back to the time we told him to make dynasty. By a man named Ptolemy.